What we typically did was try to follow the breeze, whether it was blowing in or blowing out. It's following the breeze was the way we tried to find more cave. And ultimately these led to the great extent of the cave and some big rooms.
Herb priced an anemometer, a thing that would measure the speed of the wind. And they were $1,500 or something. So he built one for $10.53. From that, he could figure out what the volume of the cave was. He figured out that there must be over 1,000 miles of passages, and that was conservative. Later, the people who had better instruments to work with said that it's probably about 15,000 miles of cave passages.
I think they both actually are very talented. But definitely Herb was more heavier on the engineer side and Jan was heavier on the artistic side, and they were able to kind of bring that together into some beautiful things that they created.
Over the next 2 decades and more than 700 caving trips, the Conns discover and map more than 60 miles of new passages.
To map a 3D space, to represent it on a 2D piece of paper is very challenging, and you do have to have sort of an engineer's brain, but you also have to have an artistic brain because you have to make it look good. So it's actually a beautiful balance, and Herb and Jan worked really well together in that way.
The mapping is fun. A lot of people who cave don't like to map, but we always thought it was a real fun challenge.